What I've got here is a bunch of calcite. This is a cluster of calcite crystals. Here's another cluster of calcite crystals here. And in the middle here, I've got cleavage fragments. Now, I'm not going to talk about cleavage. I'm going to talk about a different physical property associated with calcite. It's actually an optical property, and it's called double refraction. And in order to see double refraction, you have to have a nice, clear piece of calcite. So this is a pretty nice one. So we'll take a closer look and explore this concept of double refraction. Here's that piece of clear calcite. And what I'm going to do is put it on this piece of paper here so that you can see the effect of double refraction. All right, and put it down there. You should be able to see the doubling of the letters and the lines that I have written there. But also, let me turn this around a little bit so you can see how they move about. All right, calcite is not unique in the effect of double refraction, but it is one of the minerals that shows it the best. Let's try another side here. Of course, the thicker the piece and the clearer the piece, the better the effect will be. All right, so that's an example of double refraction in the mineral calcite. This is another ROM of clear calcite that shows double refraction very nicely. In order to explain the process of double refraction, we're going to take a look at the calcite at an atomic level. This green rectangle here will represent the cleavage ROM. An ordinary beam of light actually vibrates in two directions at the same time. There is a horizontal component called the ordinary ray and a vertical component called the extraordinary ray. An ordinary source of light like the sun or an incandescent bulb will actually produce this sort of light vibrating in two directions at the same time. So here comes a beam of light passing through the calcite crystal structure. All right, this is the path of the ordinary ray. Notice that as it enters into the calcite, it is bent or refracts. Now, the extraordinary ray passing through the calcite is also refracted, but it is refracted more. So there are two beams of light, one that is vibrating in a vertical direction, and the other beam of light, shown there, is vibrating in a horizontal direction. What the calcite is doing is splitting the beams of light, and the light coming out is actually polarized light. Polarized light simply means that the light is vibrating all in the same direction, either as the ordinary ray or as the extraordinary ray. Now, this is the atomic structure of calcite. And you can see that it consists of blue calcium atoms, red oxygen, and the purple ones there are carbon, and that it is a very geometrical structure. Right? Now, it is this sort of a structure that interferes with the passage of the light. So here's the vertical beam of light passing through there, and you can see there's lots of atoms for this thing to interact with. As a result, this particular beam of light is slowed down. The horizontal component is also being interfered with by the structure of the calcite, but not as much. So the vertical beam is slowed down more than the horizontal, and this results in the splitting of the beam. So again, there are the two beams passing through there, and we end up with two beams of polarized light, both at 90 degrees to each other, right? The extraordinary ray and the ordinary ray. To demonstrate this concept of polarized light coming out of the calcite from the ordinary and the extraordinary rays, what I've got here is a polarizing filter for a camera. And I'm going to hold it up in front of the camera here so that you can see the effect of blocking out one of the vibrational directions. So let me bring it up a little closer to the camera lens and get around here a little bit. And I'll just rotate it. All right, so you can see just one single calcite. And I'll just turn it a little bit more. That one disappears. And another one. So what we're seeing here is a result of blocking one of the vibrational directions out with the polarizing filter so that the other one passes through. All right, the polarizing filter just blocks out one of the vibrational directions, and every 90 degrees it'll block out one and allow the other one to pass through. Double refraction in calcite.